finally the day to give Alex back his camera. As y'all may know, this one just got back from Sony not too long ago. Camera had a bit of a spill, the display snapped off. Alex, bless his heart, had basically the exact same camera. I use it for a while, I've been using it for a while, and he wants it back. I'm doing a project with him and Lex. It's very helpful for him to have a camera too, to get certain shots when I'm not there. I've had this back for like probably a few weeks now, and I've definitely had this too long, so about time I gave it back. All right. Humidity's kicked in. I know that because you can barely see me.
Hey!
It's back. You got the camera. I thought all this was coming up last Friday.
Clearly it's still sanding, so I wanted to get as much dust on top of this as we can so it doesn't get in the floors.
Let's follow Alex anywhere.
Had the project, they're about to lift up the paper, for lack of better words.
Butcher paper, it kind of looks like.
Butcher paper?
Yeah, just the wood floor protecting, put the wood floors in early, and then it's like, do everything you can to protect them.
Yeah.
You fail miserably. So. That's why we have a big sander here.
Not all the papers up. They're gonna sand this whole thing to like smooth it out before they put like the polish and all the polyurethane. But the sanding's not happening today. Before we start this gym session, you're gonna go to a mail time because that'll preface some of the stuff I'll talk about here.
Hi, mailman. Okay, see you tomorrow.
If you've been watching for a while, you've heard the name Alex Rodriguez before. It is not Alex Rodriguez from the Yankees. It is Alex Rodriguez from Bear Performance Nutrition. Alex is the brand director for BPN. He watches the vlogs, he's a great guy. He is creative as it gets. And he just hooks me up with some good stuff over at BPN. So let's look. Silly me, I was about to go for a normal knife. If you've been following, you know we don't use anything to open packages other than the Batman knife. Chinatown 2003, when this was acquired. I made up the year. It was some time long ago though. Flight pre-workout. We got creatine. This could not have come at a better time. I've been taking creatine. I definitely threw it away. Eric Freeberg recommended a creatine. I ran out of it because it comes in the dinkiest little jar. You have to order like three of them just for a month. So, perfect. It's like Alex knew. So, this is great. And then last but not least, we have EndoPump. Muscle Pump Enhancer. This provides a greater pump. I literally thought that's what creatine was for. EndoPump. I'll have to do a little more homework on this. Get back to y'all. I'm taking this right now. Perfect timing. Perfect. 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 And the scoop is at the top. How lucky is that? Don't have to go fishing for it. Is this too big of a scoop to dry? 5 grams creatine. Let's try it. There you go. On that creatine kick, I just started taking creatine for the first time since high school. I think it's working. I don't really know. Thank you, Alex. Thank you, BPN. I love y'all. I love y'all's products.
The next day.
Yep. You see it? Oh yeah, it's kind of glaring. This is the vinyl of Parker McCollum's newest album, Never Enough, signed by Parker. I now have 4 vinyls, 2 Parker McCollum, 1 Chase Rice, 1 Hardy. However, I don't have a vinyl player or whatever. What does a vinyl play on? So, collection has grown. Never Enough, Gold Chain Cowboy, Hardy, The Mockingbird and the Crow, and then this is Chase Rice, All Dogs Go to Hell, and I Hate Cowboys. Nope, backwards. I Hate Cowboys and All Dogs Go to Hell. And this is actually Chase Rice's dad. Very good album, very cool story behind that album. But anyways, although I have these 4 vinyls, I don't have a record player, so that should be next on the agenda. But anyways, okay. If y'all have been watching for a little bit, you know that I was wearing the Vans Ultra Range shoe. Yeah, the Vans Ultra Range shoe. Wildly comfortable, super, super awesome for CrossFit. They are a lifestyle shoe, but I feel like the origins of Vans are skateboarding, so I wanted to try something out. Not sure how well it's gonna work. I ordered some Nike SBs, SB meaning skateboarding. I'm gonna take you through my thought process. Vans, very flat. CrossFit shoes, very flat. Skateboarding shoes, very flat. Also with a little bit of cushion because you have to walk around a lot, you're running a lot when you're skateboarding. So in theory, or at least in my head, these would be good for CrossFit. Very simple shoe, very sleek. They kind of remind me of the simple nature of the Vans, which I like. A lot of perforation, so they should be able to breathe. I mean, they're super flexy, right? If these stink, order a new pair of the Vans Ultra Range.
Yeah, I think that's it.
All right, mail time is completed. It's time to try them out. All right, we are hopping in with Brady and Sam on a piece, rowing, overhead squats, some things. Got it? 21 thrusters, as shown. Then 21 bar muscle ups, 21 overhead squats, rest three. Reps go down, weight goes up. It's 135, 155, 185 for guys.
That sun disappears, but it's always back here when I wake up. Small town trucks buried deep in the mud never stay stuck. Some things in life you can always count on. Some things get gone, but they ain't gone for long.
Coming back from a 5-day pause. This is tough.
Old songs, bird dogs, football season, weekends, good friends, amen, Jesus. Some things leave, but they always come back. Baby, you and me, we both know that you won't. No, you won't. You can call me and say that you're on your way, but you won't. You can walk in and hug me and say you still love me, but you won't. But I know that's a lie, 'cause I know you better. You ain't nothing like old songs, bird dogs, football season, weekends, good friends, amen, Jesus. Some things leave, but they always come back. Baby, you and me, we both know that you won't. And dust to dust, I'd give anything if you let that be love. Oh, but you won't. Some things in life you can always count on. Some things get gone, but they ain't.
Can we sit down somewhere? All right. Wow, I look beautiful. First workout back after 5 days off. I was saying that I had a cookie over the weekend called Chubba Wubba. It was a Chubba Wubba cookie. I'm feeling like a Chubba Wubba right now.
Coincidence? I think not!
That was a very humbling workout. I'm excited to get back in shape. That was brutal. I don't even know which part was the worst part. Everything kind of stunk. Probably the thrusters, because I couldn't do those in one set. Yeah, so let's go get the post game from the not so married couple. Sam. All right, Police Academy update too, after post game.
I graduated.
Right.
I've arrested the same person like 3 times already. She's insane. I'm on day shift right now with a bunch of old guys. So that's good. And it's like 4,000 degrees wearing a vest, which is not ideal. But, you know, I'm like about 20 pounds lighter every day when I leave work. And that workout was butt cheeks. The thrusters made me want to die. So that's my update on that.
Brady.
The workout was hard. The thrusters were hard. The ski was hard. The muscle ups weren't bad. Overall, it was very hard though. But at the end of the day, I guess it was less hard for me than for everyone else because
you won.
I think I won. Yeah.
There you go.
I beat Sam, and that's really the only thing that matters. Some of you, if you've been watching the channel for a little bit, you've probably seen a video or two of me and Sam arguing over over rep count and stuff like that, things of that nature.
Continues to count out loud. Like, either just count or don't. Like, I don't understand.
And Sam has already abandoned the whole Sam okay. and Connor go at the same time. And great. Sam is notorious for not knowing how to count in workouts. Anyway, we're doing sets of 15 on like synchro dumbbell snatches. That's what we'd agreed upon. So we did the first set of 15, no problems. Second set of 15, we're cruising. 28, 29. I go to do the 30th rep and she puts the dumbbell down. And I'm like, what are you doing? And she was like, that was 15. And I was like, no, that was 29. And she was like, it was 30. And so I was like, okay, fine. You know what? Fine, we'll call it 30. So we end up doing one extra just in case. Cause she was like, fine, we'll do one extra just in case. Go back and check the tape. It was 29.
We'll skip to the end here.
That was supposed to be the 30th rep.
Here's us arguing.
Yeah.
Yeah, so as per usual, we got into it in the middle of a workout.
And as per usual, I was correct.
I don't know what happens to my brain when I'm counting during workouts, but in my head, I'm not intentionally trying to cut reps, but in my head, I've counted there. And I am usually wrong.
There's no telling what the hell you just did on this workout.
Oh! I've got some green grass, some Bermuda.
You actually? Wow.
Some Bermuda growing.
Backstory, Jamie bought a house.
Purchased a house,
and now has a backyard, and he is a proud owner of green grass.
Well, so I did have to pull out all of the dead grass, out like a big section of dead grass, all got pulled. They put some turf down, they put some sod down.
Okay.
And then they did nothing to maintain it for about a month straight. And then we got there, watered it, all rotted, attracted tons of flies, had like eight bags full of flies, so much so that they started growing larvae inside the bags, inside the dead bodies of all the flies. Larvae was trying to crawl out of the top of the bags. Yeah, so we had basically like a horse farm there for a while, but now we pulled out a big section of turf and tilled and topsoil and then like some peat organic stuff on top, tilled it, seeded it. 4 days later, we had little babies coming up and I've just been watering them, telling them how much I love them. Yeah, it's a hot one for them today, but we're keeping some water on them and we feel really, really good about it. And that has been Lawn Talk with Jamie Jakes. Thank you.
All right. By the way, this is the creatine that Eric recommended a while back. This is so dinky. This is what I'm currently using. You're supposed to take 5 grams. 5 grams of creatine a day. That is this scooper, right? That's 5 grams. Okay, riddle me this, everyone. We're already seeing the size difference here. Knowing that we have to take 5 grams of creatine, why would you give me a scooper? Is this for ants?
What is this?
A center for ants!
Like, 5 grams? I don't even know. Like, I don't even know. What is this? 750 milligrams. What? I even talked to Eric about this and he thinks it's ridiculous as well. So, caged, whatever. It's a good product, I'm sure. Just give me a bigger scooper. I know I'm gonna go through this like even faster, but geez, come on now. Anyways, what is the verdict on these shoes? They're actually Nyjah Houston shoes. He's a famous skateboarder. He's had a line with Nike and skateboarding shoes for a long time. They're very good. I really like them. They have a built-in tongue. So what I mean by that is this right here, it doesn't move. I don't have to tie them, which I'm a big, big fan of. I don't like tying my shoes, whether I'm walking around, working out. I don't want to tie my shoes. It's a waste of time. However, I want to point out that if you find a pair of shoes you like, and that are comfortable to walk around in, chances are you could do CrossFit in them. There's really nothing special about these shoes. They're just kinda flexible, they're flat, but you want to be flat on the ground, maybe a little bit of a heel, if anything. So really, whether it's these, or maybe even these, which these are golf shoes. You're getting my point. It doesn't matter. Is there a shoe out there that trumps them all? Honestly, probably not. There's so much personal preference that goes into the shoe, whether it's like the width, the cushion, how much stability you want, blah, 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 blah. To each their own, really, with these shoes. However, between these two shoes, the Metcon being designed for CrossFit and the Nyjah Houston very much not being designed for CrossFit, I'd pick the Nyjah Houstons over the Metcons. Of the shoes I've tried out with CrossFit, Metcons, now Nyjah Houstons, one time, so maybe in a week or month, whatever it is, if I'm constantly wearing these, I'll give another update. Of all the shoes I've worn, this is probably tied with the Vans. I wish this was a built-in tongue, right? So obviously, flappy, not flappy. People say all the time how much these suck to run in. I feel like it's like kind of like a universal thing. Same with the Nobles. I've just never heard anyone give a raving review about Nobles, so I've never even wanted to try them. I haven't ran in these yet, so I will get back to you on that. I will say the Ultra Range for running are very good. They were like enough cushion for running, even like I did Murph in them, so totally fine even with the weight vest. Running 2 miles, really no complaints, no like crazy shin splints, anything like this. Definitely got crazy shin splints in these. The Ultra Range are a lifestyle shoe, so those kind of fell apart. I was wearing them basically every day doing CrossFit for 7-8 months. They fell apart, rope climbs, everything, they got really chewed up. They're a lifestyle shoe. They're not meant for CrossFit to be beaten up in a gym, to be climbing ropes, all that stuff. Think that's why these will end up being superior. They're meant to be beaten up. They're meant to be outside. Grip tape is rubbing up against these from the skateboard, everything. So I think these will just last longer. This layer of the shoe is like very like rough, just very strong, durable shoe. So if you're looking for a new CrossFit shoe to try and you're kind of like me and you just want something maybe not everyone is wearing, I recommend them. I think they're pretty good. That is all for this one. I will see y'all in the next one. We are back to Wednesday, Sunday uploads. I've been a little lackadaisical, but we're back. This being the first Wednesday, and I will see you on Sunday. Maybe even earlier. I might just start uploading more. But Wednesdays and Sundays, for sure. Holy cannoli, I am tight. My back. Battery's about to die. This video is over. I will see y'all in the next one. Hell, baby, I wish I never loved you at all.